Hi, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Getting the voice? Getting the voice? Voice coming? Chal, great. So, there are four chapters we have to do today. Comparatively small chapter. Any problem coming here? Voice coming. Voice not clear. This is my throat. This is the clearest voice you are going to get. Normal, na? Everything normal? Everything normal? Wherever the net connection is okay, that is normal? Clear, na? Okay. Wherever eco, vico, teco, pico, teco, nico, hico, bico is happening. Check your internet connection once. Because I already got 2-3 messages. The voice is coming normally. Here coming normally again. And once check, body coming normally. Chaliye, coming normal? Great. So now, let's start. I am awesome by birth. So we'll start with the chemistry of the life. After the D and F block, metallurgy. Chali. So starting with the chemistry of everyday life, classification. Based upon the pharmacological effect. What is the meaning of classification? All this is NCERT. What is the meaning of classification based upon the pharmacological effect? That means the effect that is caused in the body, or we can say the symptom which is being treated by the drug. On the basis of that, if you classify the drug, that is called pharmacological effect classification. For example, antipyretic drugs, they cure the fever. How they cure it, where they bind, what is their molecular structure, no idea about that. Simply, which of the following drug will be antipyretic, that means will cure the fever, or antiseptic, getting painkillers, analgesics we call painkillers. Understood the idea? This classification is called pharmacological effect. Very useful for doctors, because you don't have to worry more about, after becoming a doctor, you don't have to worry more about how the specific drug is functioning. Your main concern will be, bhaiya, this is the symptom. For this symptom, this drug can be given. Number two, on the basis of drug action, whenever there is a metabolic pathway in the body, only that is responsible for any biological response of the body. Pain happening, that means some metabolic pathway is acting in a specific manner. If you can hinder that metabolic pathway, the pain will also get hindered, or pain will also get removed. So which biochemical pathway or metabolic pathway is affected by the drug? On that classification, on that basis, if we do the classification, all these drugs, let us say, work against histamine. All this class of drug, 2-3 drugs together, they can say they can act against histamine. So we'll call them antihistamine type of drugs. They will act against histamine. Now, where they are binding can be different, but which metabolic pathway they are affecting, that is same. This classification is called drug action classification. Based upon the action of drug on a particular biochemical process, for example, all antihistamines, na, they can have different receptor sites. But eventually the metabolic pathway is blocked. The same metabolic pathway is blocked. The way it is blocked can be different. Understood? But this classification is called drug action. Which biochemical process or metabolic pathway is hindered? On the basis of its structure, all the drugs who are looking similar in the structure, they are classified together. Most common example are sulfonamides. In that also, the most common example is if I put a pyridine here. Instead of R, if I put a pyridine, so pyridine sulfonamide is the most important drug of this category, where all the structures will have a sulfoamide group. Sulfoamide group. Next. On the basis of molecular target. Now, this is the classification ki bhaiya, when the drug is going, to which molecule it is going and binding. Is it going and binding to the carbohydrate or lipid or protein or nucleic acid? So, bhai sahab, this is your multiple choice question. This is your MCQ. Which of the following target a drug usually do not bind? So they will give you carbohydrate, lipid, protein, and something else. Not nucleic acid, something else. That fourth option will become the correct answer. So remember these four: carbohydrate, lipid, proteins, and nucleic acid. Now these are called target molecules. Clear? This is useful for medicinal chemist. Remember, those people who are making the drug, they should know na where the drug has to go and bind. If that drug bind to wrong place, what will happen? Side effects. If that drug will go and bind to wrong receptor site, then only the side effect will happen. Because if the drug is going and binding to the correct receptor site, side effects will be minimum. What is the meaning of side effect? Side effect means side reaction. What is the meaning of side reaction? When the reactant you are choosing, that is not reacting, some other reactant is reacting, some new product is getting formed. That is called side effect. To minimize that, you should know the molecular target very, very properly. So let's understand the drug-target interaction. It's just a small time pass you are doing. Actually, when you will go to the MBBS, you will learn this in much, much, much more detail. But here the simple funda is there. Enzyme has active site, will drug substrate will come bind to the enzyme. You will get the enzyme substrate complex. Now, there are two types of inhibition here. A drug can inhibit the substrate from binding to the enzyme. How? It can be competitive. The drug and the substrate will compete. And the drug will bind to the enzyme first, so the substrate cannot bind. Competitive mechanism. In this mechanism, where the drug will bind to the active site, where the substrate was about to bind. Second, non-competitive mechanism. In which what happened, in which the drug will go and bind somewhere else. That is called allosteric site. This site is called allosteric site, which is not the active site, which is not the site where the substrate will go and bind. But because the reaction happened here, the shape of this active site changes, so the substrate cannot recognize it. This is called non-competitive mechanism. Clear, bhai? So, for example, it is a chair. Either I will sit on the chair and Achilles sir cannot sit, or I will kick the chair so that the chair is no more available for sitting of anyone. So, if I sit on the chair with competing, that is called competitive mechanism. If I break the chair by hitting the chair in some leg or something, if I hit the chair leg and the chair get broken, not suitable for sitting at all, that means I attack the allosteric site. Non-competitive mechanism of inhibition. Then, this thing already we have done. Now, chemical messenger, bhai. What are chemical messenger? They are generally proteins. They are generally proteins. What is their role? They will transfer, receptor sites, receptor proteins are there, which are the receptor sites. Chemical messenger are small molecules. They will come, they will bind to the receptor, and the message is sent inside the cell. So messenger never enters the cell. Messenger never enters the cell. Then sir, what enters the cell? Nothing. There is a receptor protein, which is half outside, half inside the cell. So here message will be transferred without actually the messenger coming inside the body. Now, we are starting with the drugs. Histamine. This, bhai sahab, is responsible for the acid generation in the stomach. Before that, the story, brief idea I'm giving you. Initially, people use sodium bicarbonate as antacid because it is a strong base, weak acid salt. But sodium bicarbonate is sufficiently soluble in the stomach. So after reacting with all the acid, NaHCO3 will be still there in the dissociated form. Listen carefully, there is no time of repetition. So in the dissociated form, NaHCO3 will make the stomach basic, which will trigger the oversynthesis of acid, and this will not be curing the hyperacidity for a longer period of time. Why? It is even triggering the acidity production. Why? It will firstly kill the acid, then he will dissociate completely, leftover NaHCO3 dissociate completely. That will trigger even more acid formation. Then we use the other substitute, aluminium hydroxide, AlOH whole thrice, MgOH whole thrice. Magnesium, aluminium hydroxide, metal hydroxides. These are weak bases. Weak base means they will react with the acid if acid is there. If acid is not there, they will not dissociate enough. If they don't dissociate, if the acid is not there, if they don't dissociate, more acid trigger will not happen. In the case of NaHCO3, that happens. But this is also not good, yaar. This is curing the symptom, not the cause of the acidity. Later on, people realize this histamine, this nalaik thing, which is coming out from an amino acid called histidine. Histidine only get converted to histamine. Histidine biomolecule only get converted to histamine. Similar structures are there. So histamine is responsible for the generation of HCl in the stomach. So histamine is going and binding to some receptor site, generating HCl. So what we do, we take the drugs which look like histamine. See, 5-membered rings. Looking like histamine, they will go and bind to the receptor site of histamine. As a result, histamine will not be able to bind there and generate HCl. Clear, bhai? So basically, we are inhibiting the histamine from binding to the receptor site and generation of the acid. So cimetidine and ranitidine, Gentech. Chala important class of drug of antacid, cimetidine, ranitidine. Now, so in the structure, what to remember? Understand acidity. Acidity, if it is going, 5-membered ring and sulfur. These two things are enough for the time being. Clear, bhai? You can see the structure once. Mugging is almost impossible of exact structure of all the topics of this chapter. But some basic hints you can remember. 5-membered ring, histamine also have, cimetidine also have, ranitidine also have. Sulfur is present in both of them. After that, NH-NH group is there. But rough idea will be this. If they give you the structure, they will give you the structure from this chapter only. And no other structure will have this kind of a bonding of 5-membered ring and sulfur. So two will be enough for you to identify ki cimetidine is there or ranitidine is there. Clear, bhai? Then you don't have to mug up. You have to identify. Make sure that. Then we have bromphenidamine. Bromphenidamine is dimetap. And terfenidine is seldane. These are called antihistamine only. But which type of antihistamine? These are anti-allergenic. Whenever histamine is there, binding to the stomach, HCl production happens. Same histamine bind to the nose receptor, inflammation will happen. Common cold, flu, sneezing, red nose. All that is caused by hyperinflammation because of histamine. Now, here the receptor is different. Here the receptor is different. So same drug cannot work for both of them. So the drug which are antacid cannot work as anti-allergen because receptor sites are different in two different locations. Clear, right? But who are the antihistamines? I understand the idea. Antacid, cimetidine and ranitidine are also antihistamines. But when I say simply antihistamine, it means anti-allergen only. It means this one, inflammation one. Which are the example? Dimetap and Seldane. Clear, bhai? So remember these two drug names, Dimetap, Seldane. Next, tranquilizers, neurologically active drugs. Who are they? Tranquilizers are there. Analgesics are there. Neurologically active drugs. Clear? They will affect your central nervous system. That's why there is a question, ki why we should not consume the tranquilizers or analgesics by ourselves. And only by doctor prescription you should have it. Because they affect your central nervous system drastically. Clear, bhai? Now, how to remember this? Remember, I-pro, niazid, mi-pro, bamate, nardil, equanil, chor the epoxide. So, who are the tranquilizers? I-pro, niazid. I did not do any zid. I-pro, niazid. Mi-pro, bam, 8. I still ate bam. Jhandu bam, I ate. I don't know why. Nardil, my heart, male is nar, nardil, was equally distributed. Should I eat or should I not eat? Equanil, nardil, equanil. Then the doctor said, bhaiya, now leave everything like this and prepare properly. So he said, okay, sir, chhod the epoxide. Clear, bhai? Chhod the epoxide. So I-pro, niazid, mi-pro, bamate, nardil, equanil, chhod the epoxide. These are the tranquilizers. Then, who are the barbituric acid derivative? All the al, veronal, saconal, nembutal, al, 5 al are there. Anything ending with al, you can say, bhaiya, these are barbituric acid derivative. Then, if anyone is under depression, give him vanilla ice cream, valium. V-A-L-I-U-M, valium. That is also a tranquilizer we can use. Apart from that, we take serotonin. Very commonly, you might have heard serotonin in biology, so it's easy to remember comparatively. Clear, bhai? So I-pro, niazid, mi-pro, bamate. Why these two are written together, I-pro, niazid and nardil? These are written together because these are antidepressant. These are the killer. Instagram people, these are the West Side killer. टू टाइम्स ऐसे ना हे 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 आइप्रोनियाजिड एंड नरदिल क्लियर भाई किलर ऑफ किलर हूज किलर किलर ऑफ द किलर ऑफ द नॉर एड्रिनालीन किलर ऑफ द किलर ऑफ द नॉर एड्रिनालीन वेरेवर यू फील हैप्पी द हॉर्मोन रिस्पॉन्सिबल द केमिकल रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इट इन द बॉडी इज नॉर एड्रिनालीन दैट गेट डिग्रेडेड बाय द बॉडी बाय सम एंजाइम दैट एंजाइम इज किल्ड बाय दिस एंटी डिप्रेसेंट ड्रग्स हियर You can see the structure also. If you will see, you will realize that we have meprobamate and equanil. They both are nearly equal on both the side. Done. Next, barbituric acid derivative, veronal, amital, lambutal, luminal, sucanal, five of them. These derivatives are called barbiturates. They are hypnotic. Some other substances used as tranquilizers are valium, vanilla ice cream, and serotonin. So, Saurabh sir, to always no problem at all. Clear, bhai? So, vanilla ice cream. And Saurabh sir, how many places Saurabh sir coming in the inorganic chemistry bhai? SP sir Mange metallurgy impurity present there. SP sir Mange clear in the iron. Clear then who is the CM candidate? Sulfur CM candidate. Clear bhai two amino acid with sulfur. Done and then obviously serotonin. Then sorbic acid preserves the thing. It will preserve something. Sorbic acid. Sorry, sorbic acid. Clear, bhai? And then sucrose, trichloro derivative of sucralose. Sorry, sucralose. Trichloro derivative of sucrose. Clear, bhai? Chali. Sucrose also. Will I be affected by the Torrens reagent filing solution as a sucrose? No. Understood, bhai? Dekh raha, whole chemistry revolves around me only. I was the epicenter of this devastation which happened in your life. SP mixing. Aur kya? SP mixing. SP mixing. Last class. MOT. Now, non-narcotic and narcotic analgesics, bhai. Non-narcotic means when you will take aspirin, you will not be like, bhai, I need aspirin now every morning, evening, night, sir. I am getting convulsions, sir. Aspirin. That will not happen with you. Getting it? This kind of thing happened with morphine, codeine, heroin. Clear? Not Samantha type heroin. Heroin means this drug, heroin. Clear, bhai? Then, non-narcotic analgesics. Which are non-narcotic analgesics here, bhai? For example, aspirin is there. Aspirin is also very important for preventing the heart attack. If you are going to do something which can give heart attack to others, always take one aspirin along with you. Give them the aspirin first, then tell them the news that you are about to tell. It will prevent the heart attack. Clear, bhai? Understood? For example, you took your friend's car. Clear, bhai? Then you became a heavy driver. Then car is not there, only steering wheel is left. Now you have to go and tell to your friend. So go to the medical store, buy one aspirin, dissolve in water, give it to him or her, whosoever car is that. After that, tell them, this is the leftover part of your car. He will be surprised or she will be surprised why heart attack did not come. Then tell them, aspirin prevents heart attack. Understood the idea, bhaiya? Narcotics analgesic, bhai. Morphine, codeine, heroin. How to remember the structure? Dekho, bhai. Whatever happened, heroin is from Tollywood or Bollywood or Hollywood. Cannot live without AC. Clear, bhai? So whenever there is two AC on the left side also, right side also, OAC, OAC, Rendu AC required for heroin. Done. Now C for codeine, CO, codeine. So OCH3 on one side and OH on the other side. And morphine, MO, morphine, 2OH on. Basic skeletal is same. Whether you are reading zoology or you are reading chemistry, both the structure, all three structures are important. If they are narcotic, that means you will get addicted to them. Why we are using them? They are used for extremely high pain. Clear, bhai? Post-operative pain, cardiac pain, terminal cancer or childbirth. Very, very high pain. Now we are reading about the discovery of prontosil. Clear, bhai? Understand what happened. Syphilis was getting spread in the World War time. It's a sexually transmitted disease. So the first drug that was developed against that, against speriocheat or speriocheat, whatever you want to call it, speriocheat, was salvarsan. Salvarsan had a problem ki salvarsan had arsenic double bond arsenic, and arsenic is chala dangerous for the human beings, but because it was no dangerous for the speriocheat, we were using it even though there were chala side effects. In fact, Paul Ehrlich won Nobel Prize for it also, but he did not stop working. He kept on working for the next 30 years. Then he realized ki azo dye instead of arsenic contain N double bond N. So the structures are similar, but nitrogen is very less harmful for the human body. So he started working upon azo dye. He found that azo dyes are not binding to any random tissue. They are going and binding specifically to some tissue only. So what he did, he thought here N double bond N can be used as a good transporter. And I will give the revolver, the knife, AK-47, and send them to the body. They can kill the speriocheat very easily. Clear, bhai? So N double bond N being specifically binding to the tissue gave the idea to Paul Ehrlich ki structurally, salvarsan and azo dye, they are almost similar. So why not use azo dye? It might be less harmful. So by doing this development, he finally was able to develop prontosil. Prontosil was the first effective. People have this confusion. So salvarsan was the first drug of prontosil. Salvarsan was the first drug. But the first effective drug against this was prontosil. Why? This is not very effective. This is killing the humans. Not killing, but affecting human beings adversely. This was not affecting the human beings adversely. Side effects were very much controlled because of the arsenic being replaced by nitrosanate. So this is the first effective drug against kya? Syphilis. So prontosil, later on it was found ki actually prontosil is not the hero. Actual hero is this blue highlighted part which goes in the body. This part get degraded and you get sulfanilamide. Clear? Sulfanilamide. Sulfanilamide. Understood? So prontosil, this is the main active component. So then people thought, here, why to send prontosil every time for the work? Let's make a new class of drug, which is called sulfa drugs now, or sulfonamide class of drug now. Classification based upon structure. Most common one and most important one is sulfapyridine, which I told in the beginning of this lecture also. Then, going ahead, bactericidal, penicillin, aminoglycosides, aflozaxins. These are bactericidal. They kill the bacteria. Bacteriostatic, hinder the growth of bacteria. Erythromycin, tetracycline, chloramphenicol, these three you have mugged up in biology also. Make sure that you mug up again. Then you have to remember narrow spectrum and wide spectrum antibiotics here. Who are narrow spectrum? They will act upon either gram positive or gram negative, not both of them. Broad, both of them they can kill or hinder. Then limited spectrum will kill a specific class of bacteria. Specific bacteria, not the whole class, not the whole gram positive, not the whole gram negative. Some bacteria, limited spectrum. Clear, bhai? Now understand, who are the broad spectrum? Classic example is penicillin G is narrow spectrum. Penicillin G, very famous in biology, penicillin G. Penicillin G is narrow spectrum. But the synthetic modifications were done, and then ampicillin and amoxicillin, these are the synthetic derivatives of penicillin G. These are a broad spectrum. Clear, bhai? Then chloramphenicol. Chloramphenicol is chala awesome, yaar. Why? He works from head to toe everywhere. See, broad spectrum, easily absorbed by the gastrointestinal tract, means you can take it orally, you can eat it. No need to give in the veins and all directly, intramuscular, intravenous, not required. Then hence can be given orally in the case of typhoid. Chalo typhoid. Dysentery, chalo dysentery. Acute fever, certain form of urinary infection, urine bhaiya. Meningitis, swelling of the, what we should say, brain or skull, means something like that. I remember brain, but I'm not very confident with the brain. I remember this, that skull has to be cut for this. But whatever happens, you can search. You are doctors, you will be able to search it. Pneumonia. So any random thing can be cured here. Because broad spectrum. Then vancomycin, aflozaxin are the other broad spectrum. Remember them, vancomycin, aflozaxin. Then dicitizidine. Dicitizidine, achha, membrane swelling. Theek hai. Maybe brain membrane only then. Cerebrum or something. Whatever. I don't have to give this medicine to anyone. क्लियर भाई? डन, आई एम नॉट हैविंग दैट इंटेंशन. चलिए, डाइसिडाजरीन, 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 क्लियर भाई? डाइसिडाजरीन इज अ लिमिटेड स्पेक्ट्रम, इट किल्स स्पेसिफिक स्ट्रेन्स ऑफ कैंसर ओनली. Now, remember this is called lactam. Lactam, cyclic amide, C double bond of N in a cycle. Cyclic amide are called lactam. So, yeah, penicillin G have lactam ring, just like caprolactam. Caprolactam was the monomer of nylon 6. It also have cyclic amide that is also called caprolactam because amino caproic acid. That's why caprolactam. This is called beta lactam, but does not matter which lactam. But lactam is a cyclic ring, easy to remember. Chloramphenicol. If someone asks you what is the structure of chloramphenicol, just don't be blind in the exam. You will get the answer. Why? Chlorol. So rendu chlor, rendu all. Chloramphenicol and phenyl also there. Getting the idea? Phenyl. Just if you are not blind, you'll be able to easily get the answer. Now these two are chala important here. Detol, Detol, chloroxylenol, terpineol. Make sure that you do NCERT exemplar question also. Which is the question? The question was, or you can do our DET paper questions also. There also you will find the IUPAC name of chloroxylenol and terpineol. These are the two components of Detol. Very to the power infinity important. The structure you have to remember. Now you have to remember for these two. Remaining you forget, no problem. Now bithionol. Used in Lifebuoy and all soaps are there, na? Antiseptic soaps. We use bithionol. Thio, sulfur. Bi, two side. All. You can see very symmetrical. Bithionol. Clear, bhai? Then, anti-fertility drugs. Bhaiya, dekhe. Idea is very simple. We have to suppress the ovulation for longer period of time. So rather than relying upon the natural progesterone and estrogen, what we do, we give the synthetic modifications, not modification, synthetic mimicry. Talking about mimicry, one thing I missed here, talking about mimicry in the beginning, two things are there. Which are those? Agonist, antagonist. Agonists are those who mimic the natural messenger, who work like natural messenger. So whenever the natural messenger is less and you want to increase the natural messenger response, give a drug which can act like the natural messenger. Sometimes the natural messenger is giving a chadda message, ki bhaiya cause the pain, cause the depression. For that we give a drug which will be antagonist, working against the natural messenger. Coming back to this, these two are going to work like progesterone and estrogen. So what happens, bhaiya, how to remember the name? Noorethindrone. Noor is a girl. She had a very thin drone. Very thin drone was there. So noorethindrone. Next, ethinyl estradiol. Very easy. Ethinyl. Estra, middle part estra. Diol. Clear, bhai? Major difference, if you will see, ethinyl here also, but instead of diol, you have OH and double bond O. A little oxidized form, we can say. Clear, bhai? So noorethindrone and novestrol or ethinyl estradiol is there, used as anti-fertility drug. Now, sweetening agent. These people will not provide calories, but will give the taste to the food. Aspartame is made up of two amino acid derivatives. Aspartic acid part and phenylalanine part. So we are calling it aspartame. Aspartame. From aspartic acid word. Next. Saccharin. How much time sweet? 550 times. Then sucralose, trichloro derivative of sucrose. Sucrose only, which is made up of glucose and fructose, but trichloro derivative, three chlorines are there, 600 times sweeter. Elitane sweetness cannot be controlled by 2000 times sweet. Problem with aspartame is that it is not stable at cooking temperature. Elitane cannot be controlled because very high sweetness is there. Achha, elitame also contains amide here. Elitame also contains the amide linkage. Just like aspartame. Next, last. Sucralose is the most widely used. Why? Because it is stable at cooking temperature and it can be controlled. Understood? Now, पीपल गेट कंफ्यूज सर, सुक्रोलोज इज मोर वाइडली यूज्ड और एस्पार्टिल? भैया इफ द क्वेश्चन कम्स इज द मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड स्वीटनिंग एजेंट, एस्पार्टिल इज द आंसर. व्हाई यू आर राइटिंग नीट एग्जाम? So then why you are saying sucralose, sucralose, sucralose again and again? Because it is used in that sugar-free bottle comes na yellow color. Real life, we see sucralose more. But all this diet sugar, diet coke, sorry, not sugar, diet coke, getting diet ice creams, in all these we are using the aspartame. So most widely used, if they ask you, neat examination, aspartame. Clear, bhai? Appears like sugar, closest to the real sugar, sucralose. Then soaps are there, bhaiya, toilet soap made by best alkali, best NaOH, KOH we will use, will be making by that. Then bhai, then next, soap that float in water by beating the air bubble. Clear? So density become less, floats in water. Transparent soap, if you use ethanol, ethanol will be easily evaporated as a solvent, you will get the transparent soap. Medicated soap, we had bithionol or something, bithionol. Shaving soap contain glycerol, which prevent the rapid drying. Clear? Also for more leather, we add rosin. Rosin makes more leather. Clear, bhai? It forms sodium rosinate, which leathers well. Laundry soap contains sodium rosinate, silicate, borax, all these are fillers. To make the soap rough and to give more and more leather, rosinate. Soap chips, you just put creamstone ice cream type, put the liquid soap and then peel it off from the cold cylinder. Peel it off, you will get the soap chips. Then soap granules, bubbles of soap dried, miniature soap bubbles dried, you will get soap granules. Then scouring agent is used for scrub. Scrub, you say na, scrub, that is the scouring soap, scrubs. They contain small, small granules, you might have felt also. Those granules are abrasive, which are pumice. Pumice is solid sol. Remember, pumice. Pumice stone, solid sol. Surface chemistry, revise today. Revise today. Pumice stone, solid sol. Revise the table today of the surface chemistry. Finely divided sand, builders like sodium carbonate, trisodium phosphate, carbonate phosphates are there. Builders make the soap act more rapidly. Now, what to remember here in the detergent? These detergent, firstly understand, soap contains COO minus, detergent contain SO3 minus. So yeah, SO3 minus, these are anionic detergent. So SDS, sodium dodecyl sulfate and sodium lauryl sulfate. This thing you will find in the toothpaste also. So your Surf Excel and your toothpaste are made up of the same detergent, that is sodium lauryl sulfate. So don't start brushing your teeth using Surf Excel because other things are also there. Done. Next. Cationic detergent, cetyl trimethyl ammonium bromide, very expensive because germicidal property is also there. Germicidal property also there. Very, very expensive as compared to remaining detergent, but used in what the people apply? Conditioners. Conditioners. That's why the conditioners are expensive. Clear? As compared to shampoos. Now, this is non-ionic type. Non-ionic type, stearic acid and polyethylene glycol. The same ethylene glycol which is used for making terylene, used for making glyptal, is the same thing which is used for making this also. That is non-ionic detergent, used for liquid dishwashing, Vim liquid. Clear, bhai? Then, what is the action of the mechanism of the cleaning of this? This also works in the same way, micellization. Only difference is that hydrophobic, hydrophilic group, how to recognize? Hydrocarbon chain is hydrophobic, water heating. And remaining chain, leftover chain is hydrophilic part. If someone asks you, detergents are biodegradable? Yes, they are. But if you are having more branching, they are less biodegradable. So unbranched chain can be biodegraded more easily and hence the pollution is prevented. This is the end of chemistry in Prati Rozalu, Rozalu Jeevanam. Not matching? Matching, not matching? Matching? Chale, bahut badhiya. Next. Next, we are starting with D and FN coordination. Clear, bhai? Warm-up happened. Chemistry today was warm-up only. That's not the actual topic we came here for. Started with that so that the latecomers can come and those who came quickly in the morning, they can get fresh. क्लियर भाई, बिकॉज इफ यू वोक अप जस्ट नाउ, है ना सोनिया, समटाइम्स हाफ एन आवर ऑफ इनिशियल वार्म अप रिक्वायर्ड. प्लीज गिव मोर टाइम फॉर कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड DNF. बिल्कुल आई विल गिव मोर टाइम, आई विल गिव यू 5 days. एवरी डे आई विल टीच फ्रॉम नाउ. ठीक है, more, even more time required, 1 month I will teach. क्या यार, हाँ जी चलिए लेट्स स्टार्ट. फर्स्टली पैलेडियम कॉन्फिगरेशन यू हैव टू से. नन भाई समर इज सेइंग सर नीट एग्जाम विल बी ओवर आफ्टर 5 days. गुड दैट यू अंडरस्टूड द पन फाइनली. पंथ नहीं पन, PUN. आई डिड नॉट नो दैट द फ्यूचर डॉक्टर्स आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द सरकैज़म आल्सो. मेटलर्जी कंप्लीटेड, हाँ 3 times कंप्लीटेड. Today not completed. Today it will be completed after this. If you allow me to teach, I'll be able to complete. Otherwise, this is what you want to do. I can do it whole day. ठीक, let's start. Palladium. Palladium has 4D10 configuration. 4D10. Now starting with the lattice. So first two are HCP. Next two are BCC. Then cut BCC. Where cut? Manganese cut. Cut BCC. And below cut and BCC, you will have HCP, HCP. Next 3 are CCP. Easy to remember in that manner. So HCP, HCP, BCC, BCC, cut BCC. Cut BCC means below that HCP will come. Then CCP, CCP, CCP. Who are not having proper structure are manganese, zinc, cadmium, mercury. Chalo, these are not transition element. These are not transition element. Zinc, cadmium, mercury are not transition element. These are D-block element, but they are not regarded as transition elements. So, even though they are not transition element, we can understand their logic that they are not having good packing as compared to the remaining transition metal. The only Satyanashi transition metal with chadda packing is manganese. Because of that, when you check the boiling point order, the manganese causes a dip because of chadda packing. Whereas chromium is maximum. Why? Because chromium configuration is S1D5. There are 6 unpaired electrons. 6 unpaired electron means maximum unpaired electron. Maximum unpaired electron means automatically maximum attraction. Because metal attraction depends upon valence electrons. Attraction of metal depends upon valence electron. So chromium, then molybdenum, then tungsten. Tungsten has the highest melting point in the whole D block. Or we can say in the whole periodic table. Now 5D more than 4D more than 3D is there in general, except this part, this is CGS, copper, gold, silver. Copper maximum, then gold, then silver for only the last element here, in the last transition element here. Otherwise, if they ask you minimum melting point, minimum enthalpy atomization in the D block, 3D series minimum enthalpy atomization, minimum melting point, 3D series, zinc, khatam, end. क्लियर भाई, डन, नो नीड टू थिंक ट्वाइस. सर जिंक इज नॉट हेयर, तो क्या हो गया, इज नॉट नॉन ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट. चाला चड्डा बॉन्डिंग एंड चाला चड्डा स्ट्रक्चर. नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू दिस टेबल, यार दिस टेबल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ यू रिमेंबर एंथैल्पी एटमाइजेशन, रिमेंबर टीवी, टाइटेनियम, वेनेडियम, वेनेडियम मैक्सिमम, टाइटेनियम सेकेंड हाइएस्ट. दे रिक्वायर सो मच एनर्जी टू बिकम एटम that they will not start the reaction at room temperature. So these are, titanium, vanadium are, TV are, kinetically inert at room temperature towards HCl. It will not react with HCl at room temperature because of high enthalpy atomization, TV, titanium and vanadium. Very important. Next, ionization enthalpy, one irregular trend is there, but 2 and 3 very regular trends are there, left to right. Ionization enthalpy increases. Left to right, ionization enthalpy increases. Only Satyanash happens in the case of manganese. Why? Because IE2, we are considering second ionization enthalpy. IE2, that means Mn2 plus configuration, if I check, it is D5 half filled. Stable configuration. So whenever you get a stable configuration after releasing electron, the ionization enthalpy is lesser than expected. So manganese will be somewhere here, 1509. Little lesser than 1592. After that, again, increase. Then again, Satyanash happens at Zn2+, which is D10. Again, you have fully filled configuration. Again, there will be a dip in the ionization enthalpy. So how to remember where dip will come? Mn2+, Zn2+ for IE2. And Fe3+ for IE3. Why? Because yellow, dirty fellow Fe3+ lives with pinky Mn2+, they both are D5. And whenever D5 configuration will come, ionization enthalpy dip will come. You can check ionization enthalpy number 3, a dip comes at Fe3+, because Fe3+ is again yellow, dirty fellow D5. D5 half filled configuration, that's why initial enthalpy is lesser than expected. So only this exception is there for IE2 and IE3. Next, radius. Remember, by radius decrease, then approximately equal. This is 127 printing error in NCRT, approximately equal, and then sudden jump at zinc. Already in the last class, we have discussed. Now, SRP value. Two SRP values are there, very, very important, bhai. Two SRP values are there. One, N2+/N, and only copper is there whose value is positive. That means copper is even less reactive than hydrogen. Copper is even less reactive than hydrogen. So can copper react with HCl? No. Can copper react with HNO3? Yes or no? No? Yes. Are laughs with zinc says no to copper, forgot kya? So, but copper less reactive than hydrogen. Haan, toh, who said hydrogen? I said HNO3. Copper will react with HNO3 means copper will react with NO3-. Will copper react with HNO3 hydrogen release? Never. Copper can never release hydrogen. Copper can never displace hydrogen from its compound. But copper can form copper nitrate and NO2 can be released. NO3- can react. Clear, bhai? Going ahead. 3+2, 2+ value, chala important. M3+2, 2+. Here, only three people have positive value, that is cobalt, manganese, iron. That means they become 3+2, 2+ happily. Positive SRP means happily. That means they get reduced happily. That means they are awesome or they are good oxidizing agent. Cobalt and manganese 3+ are very good, best oxidizing agent. Fe3+ value is 0.77. Now, this means that Fe3+ to Fe2+ conversion is spontaneous with a smile. 2+2, 3+ is non-spontaneous, but it is not highly non-spontaneous. Conversion is possible. That is why every Tom, Dick and Harry oxidizing agent is coming. He is able to oxidize Fe2+2, 3+, Cr2O7-2-, MnO4-, chlorine water, HNO3. Anyone can convert Fe2+2, 3+ easily. But try to understand, because of this factor, Fe3+ act like a catalyst. In which reaction? In the reaction of I- with Marshall. Marshall is peroxo disulfate. In this reaction, Fe3+ act like a catalyst. How? Fe3+ goes to I-, take his electron, goes to Marshall and say, Marshall, bro, take the electron from I-, he was crying on the other day. So Marshall will take the electron. So what happened? Fe3+ took electron, became Fe2+. Fe2+ went to Marshall, gave the electron back, became Fe3+ again. So by the end of reaction, there is no change you will observe in Fe3+. It will be coming out as Fe3+ only, but it participated in the reaction. Why? Because 3+2, 2+ and 2+2, 3+ conversion is easy. So who is the catalyst in this case? Fe3+. Understand? Now Marshall is overmotivated. Yeah, remember this. I'm going to explain this in detail. Now, who are the best oxidizing agent? Cobalt 3+. Second best oxidizing agent, Mn3+. Best cobalt, then Mn3+. Now, talking about the remaining three, for example, titanium, vanadium, chromium. For them, 3+2, 2+ conversion is not spontaneous. Clear, right? That means 2+2, 3+ conversion will be spontaneous. So these three people who had positive value, they were oxidizing agent. These people who have negative value of 3+2, 2+, that means they are +2, will be good reducing agent. If I ask you, chromium 2 plus plus H plus gives you chromium 3 plus plus H2. Is this reaction feasible? You will say, sir, yes, feasible. Why feasible? Sir, because 2 plus 2, 3 plus can be done. Sir, titanium, vanadium, chromium, 3 plus 2, 2 plus will not come. But 2 plus 2, 3 plus will go. Opposite will be possible. One of the thing will be possible. Either forward or backward. So for cobalt, manganese, iron, plus 3 to plus 2 conversion possible. That means oxidizing agent plus 3. And for the remaining 3, if vanadium 2 plus, chromium 2 plus, they are good reducing agent because they will be oxidized to plus 3. Next, density left to right increase. Here also increase you will find. Approximately close enough. But if you write 2 decimal places, you will see increasing. But there is a dip at zinc. So zinc density is less. Zinc melting point is minimum, atomization minimum in the 3D series. Clear, bhai? Next, understand, yesterday also I said chromium 6, molybdenum 6, tungsten 6. Chromium plus 6 will be least stable, tungsten will be most stable in the plus 6. Because of that, Cr2O7 2 minus is a good oxidizing agent. MOO3, WO3 are not. So top to bottom, highest oxidation stability increases in the D block. In the inert pair effect, top to bottom, lower oxidation state stability was increasing. Clear? Next. In this table, what to remember by? Understand, higher oxidation state, I minus ledu, lower oxidation state, F minus ledu. That means for copper in plus one, F minus is not there. Copper fluoride is not there in plus one. But in the higher, that is plus two, copper iodide is not there. You get Cu2I2, which is copper plus one only. You will not get CuY2. Clear, bhai? Done. Janvi Marshall will come. Don't worry. Clear, bhai? Clear. Cu2I2, but not CuY2. Plus 2, iodide ledu. Similarly, iron, FeI3 will not exist. Higher oxidation state of Fe is plus 3. Does not exist with iodide. Simple funda, bhai. If you go to even higher oxidation state, even bromide chloride will not exist. Highest oxidation state, iodide. Bromide also possible, chloride also possible, not existing. So higher the oxidation state, more chances of fluoride being there. And lower the oxidation state, more chances of iodide being there. Clear, bhai? Now, they can ask you, in the highest oxidation state like VF5, CrF6, will chromium show CrCl6? Will vanadium show VCl5? Not possible. They are at so much high oxidation state that they will oxidize Cl minus Br minus I minus. Done, bhai. Coming to the next point. Cobalt CuF3 is stable and chromium and vanadium F5 and F6 is stable. If they ask you reason for it, understand. A compound is stable means bonds are munchy. Munchy bonds. Then only the compound is stable. Munchy bond means what? Munchy bond means this is cobalt plus 3. More oxidation state, more covalent nature. Less oxidation state, more ionic nature. For ionic compounds, the bond strength is measured with respect to lattice enthalpy. To break the ionic bond, the energy required is called lattice enthalpy. To break the covalent bond, the energy required is called bond enthalpy. So VF6 and VF5 and CrF6, VF5 and CrF6, they are stable because of high bond and they are same thing. Bond enthalpy, lattice enthalpy are same thing. Getting it? You are more successful if you get AIR1 in NEET examination or AIR1 in JEE examination. They are similar. Getting it? For BIPC, we say NEET. For engineering aspirant, we say JEE. In the same way, for ionic compound, we say lattice enthalpy. And for covalent compound, we say bond enthalpy is high. That's the reason. Going ahead, who is the Shankar Dada and who is the Shrikant? So, yes, Shankar Dada is oxygen. Oxygen can show up to, bhai sahab, plus 7 with manganese. But fluorine can show only up to plus 4 with manganese. Why, sir? Simple funda is there. If you take 4 oxygen, because of multiple bond formation tendency, he can show multiple bonding. So for each oxygen 2 bond, so manganese will be able to show up to placate, but placate of manganese does not exist. You can understand only 4 oxygen are enough to reach up to 8. Example, OSO4. There are 4 fluorine, you can reach only up to +4. So oxygen will have more tendency to show the higher oxidation state of central atom due to multiple bond formation tendency. Now colors, how to remember, bhai? Number one, firstly, what happened? Blue party happened. In blue party, vanadium went party animal, total bill $8. Who else came in the blue? Copper and chromium came. Out of $8, half the amount vanadium paid, +4. Remaining half, $2 chromium and copper paid. Copper 2 plus is blue, we remember. So remember chromium now. Chromium is the main culprit here. So what happened? When you got chromium 2 plus blue color, chromium understood ki vanadium is crack. He is paying half the money. Remaining half, we 2 people have to pay. So next party also I will go. Then vanadium threw a party at his house. That is V for vanadium, V for violet. Violet party. Again, $8 bill came. But this time vanadium ditched. Vanadium said, bro, last time I paid half the amount, you paid $2. This time I will pay $2 only. So $2 he has paid out of 8, 6 left. Chromium came with his best friend manganese. Now they both have to pay $3 each, violet party. Clear, bhai? Done. Next. This is not very correct actually, but NCERT is writing it, so violet party. Done. Otherwise, Cr3 plus is mostly greenish in color, Cr2O3. But doesn't matter. Violet party. Then what happened? Then everyone boycotted vanadium. Yeah, vanadium is paying sometimes more, sometimes less. We are not going to vanadium party. Then vanadium said, sorry, yaar, don't give me red signal. Come to my party. Come to green signal. So green party he gave. He said, whatever the bill will come. Firstly, I will order less. I will order only $7. So that the bill is lesser. Then we will divide equally. If $1 will come extra, I will pay. Because of this iron and nickel, these two came to the party. Bill came $7, 2, 2, 2, 6. So vanadium has to pay one extra, that is vanadium 3 plus green party. Clear, bhai? So Fe 2 plus green, Fe 3 plus yellow, yellow, dirty fellow, Mn 2 plus pinky. Cobalt 2 plus cobalt 3 plus are in equilibrium, pink and blue color. Pink and blue color, equilibrium. Next, interstitial compound by statement type of question, high melting point, very hard, retain metallic conductivity means they are also metallic, they are also conductor, interstitial compounds are also conductor. Then they are chemically inert, not reactive, inert, statement type. Now, so important compound of transition metal, firstly, this order, bhaiya, mug up again and again, I am saying still people are doing it wrong and again asking the same question in the paper discussions now. Clear, bhai? This is the last time you are hearing this question. After this, you will directly hear this question in the NEET examination. And there is no paper discussion of NEET exam. I think you know that. Clear? So if anyone was waiting for the last class, this is the last class. And IPO Hindi. Now, some important compounds of transition metal. One thing I will write here. CrO, Cr2O3, CrO3. Now see carefully, bhai. Basic, amphoteric, acidic. As the oxidation state increases, acidic nature increases. V2O3, V2O4, V2O5, bhai. Basic, less basic, amphoteric, acidic. V2O5 is acidic, but mostly amphoteric, but mostly acidic. Yeah. Clear? Now, understand, conceptual thing coming. If acidic oxide goes in water, acidic oxides goes in water, they form anion. Acid, A for acid, A for anion. SO3, H2SO4, SO4 2 minus, CO3, CO2, CO3 2 minus. Any acid oxide will go, acidic oxide will go into water, they will form anion. Clear? Basic oxide, cation. Acidic oxide, anion. Basic oxide, cation. Acidic oxide, anion. Basic oxide, cation. So what will amphoteric form? Sir, both कैटायन एंड एनायन, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एम्फोटेरिक ना यार. बट ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट शुड बी सेम भाई, ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट शुड बी सेम एज दैट ऑफ द ऑक्साइड इन दीज केसेस. दैट्स हाउ यू कैन मैच द ऑप्शन. You don't have to exactly match which cation, which anion. You have to just remember amphoteric means both ions will come. Which cation, which anion is none of your concern. You just check the option where the oxidation state is matching with the oxide plus 555. Done, bhai. Clear. These are acidic oxides. Already we have discussed. Going ahead. Now, remaining compounds of D block element, we have MnO4 minus and Cr2O7 2 minus. Quickly check one by one, I'm explaining them. How to make Cr2O7 2 minus? You take FeCrO4. Those who are not able to listen for 30-40 second, topic will get lost. FeCrO4 with aqueous Na2CO3, you will get Na2CrO4. Now Na2CrO4 will get converted to Cr2O7 2 minus. In which medium? Answer is very simple. CrO4 2 minus will become Cr2O7 2 minus in the acidic medium, and Cr2O7 2 minus becomes CrO4 2 minus in the basic medium. So you are saying it is simple, but we have to mug up. Don't mug up. Understand what the logic. Simple logic is that CrO4 2 minus, CrO4 2 minus, when they come close to each other, then only they will dimerize. Na? When they will come close, then only they will dimerize. Ab yaar, two negative people will come close, kya? Or they will rappel each other. Bolo bhai, Kavya, what do you think? Will they rappel or will they come close? Rappel. So we have to make them come close, give them H plus, H2CrO4, H2CrO4, beautiful hydrogen bonding will happen. Then they will come close, then dehydration happens, and then you get Cr2O7 2 minus. Dimer is there, you want to break it, give a nucleophile OH minus, it will break. Understood the idea? Simple, easy to remember in this case. Now going ahead. Now we are out of this. If I use, instead of Na2CO3, I use K2CO3, I will get K2CR2O7 instead of Na2CR2O7. Na2CR2O7 is used as oxidizing agent in organic chemistry, and it is more soluble than K2CR2O7. So out of sodium potassium salt, sodium salts are more soluble. Achha, in the soap, potassium soaps are more, softer for the skin. Potassium soaps. Clear? And here, sodium salts are more soluble in water. So remember that. Now, this is about the Na2CR2O7 preparation method. KMnO4 preparation. Here we start from MnO2, we oxidize them. Oxidizing agent can be O2 or HNO3. It will become MnO4 2 minus, which is plus 6. Achha, this is not the compound that you are looking for. You are looking for MnO4 single minus. This, bhai sahab, is D1 configuration. D1 means it is paramagnetic. It is not dia. Unpaired electron is there. Paramagnetic. One more important thing. Color. Na2CrO4 is yellow in color. And Na2CrO7 2 minus is orange in color. Here, this is green in color. But when MnO4 minus is there, you can convert it to MnO4 minus by two pathway now. Either plus 6 to plus 7 is very tough to do. Use electricity. Awesome thing. Electricity can oxidize anyone. Remember, F minus cannot become F2. Nah. But F minus can become F2 only by electricity. Electrolytic oxidation. No other compound is there in this world which can convert F minus to F2 as per our syllabus. Actually, one compound is there, H4XeO4, but ignore, that much in depth we don't have to go. NCRT says F minus will not become F2, it will become F2 only by electrolytic oxidation. Next, so MnO4 minus can be made by electricity, electrolytic oxidation, or disproportionation in the acidic medium. It will disproportionate. Disproportionation means plus 6 will become plus 7, also plus 6 will become MnO2 also. Okay, bhai? Done. So MnO4 2 minus can become MnO4 minus by electrolytic oxidation or by disproportionation. One more method is there. Mn2 plus, you can imagine Mn2 plus to MnO4 minus should be so tough, because from plus 4 also, plus 6 only reached easily. After that, we have to use a lot of tantrums to go up to plus 7. But I am saying ki there is a possibility of converting manganese from +7, +2 to +7 directly. Now, how much change? 5 change in the oxidation state we can directly do. Here too, for 2 change also, here so much problem was there. And that is done only because we have motivated Marshall in the last reaction. Remember, Fe3 plus motivated Marshall. Now the Marshall became so much over motivated. In the last 3 days also, Slaber over and got selected by. Clear? Marshall. Done? So keep the spirit high. Done? A bad phase can come where you might not be able to oxidize I minus. I minus, pata hai? I minus in the last class got oxidized by air also. Hi plus O2. When air can also oxidize Hi, and H2O2 minus failed. What does it mean? H2O2 minus Marshall is stupid oxidizing agent. No, it was just deviated. When you know your true capacity, you might be able to oxidize manganese from +2 to +7 also. What the thing electricity can do himself, that you again can do alone without any problem. Clear, bhai? Chaliye, going ahead. Preparation method, done. Talking about reactions here. So Cr2O7 2 minus becomes Cr3 plus. Acidic, basic, both medium. MnO4 minus becomes Mn2 plus in the acidic medium. And MnO2 in alkaline medium or neutral medium. Faintly alkaline or neutral medium. Achha, one reaction. KMnO4 on heating na? KMnO4 plus 7 on heating becomes K2MnO4 plus MnO2. This is not disproportionation. MnO4 minus can never disproportionate. Why? Anyone in the highest oxidation state or anyone in the lowest oxidation state can never disproportionate. Disproportionation means further oxidation, further reduction. Is already highest, it cannot disproportionate. So on heating, it is becoming K2MnO4 plus MnO2. It is simply reduction of manganese from +7 to +6 and +4. So then who is getting oxidized? This chacha here, oxygen. He will come out as O2. This will get oxidized. So on heating, KMnO4, O2 preparation method we have done in the last class, KClO3, KMnO4 heating, you get O2. Higher oxygen salt on heating gives O2. That's there. Now, In this case, we can understand basic medium MnO2 is more stable. Now, reactions of K2Cr2O7 and KMnO4 we can see. Simple funda is there, yaar. Sn plus 2, 2 plus 4. Every Tom, Dick and Harry will convert Fe2 plus 2, 3 plus. Easy one. Same to same here, I minus 2, I2. Here also, I minus 2, I2. Other you can take C2O4 2 minus CO2. NO2 minus NO3. These are basic oxidation. No one is going to ask this much. Clear? C2O4 2 minus can be converted to CO2 by... I've exchanged some of the reactions. Okay. Clear? But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. What matter that I'm writing by? Where the questions come? Because remaining there, you will answer correct only. Because they can both can oxidize. What matter that I'm writing? For both of them, acidic KMnO4 and K2Cr2O7, any medium, I minus becomes I2 and H2S becomes sulfur. This matters. That means minus 1 to 0 of iodide and minus 2 to 0 of sulfur. But in the alkaline or faintly neutral medium, faintly alkaline or neutral medium, what will happen? Listen carefully. I minus will not stop at I2. It will go up to IO3 minus. Plus 5. Proves that he is a better oxidizing agent in alkaline medium. One more, S2O3 2 minus. Listen carefully, bhai. People who have brains, listen carefully. So those who don't have brain, they also listen carefully, but with the intention of mugging. S2O3 2 minus will become SO4 2 minus in the faintly alkaline or neutral medium. Sir, how is that relevant? Understand, S double bond, O single bond, O minus, single bond, O minus is called thiosulfate. Thiosulfate. Here, this sulfur is minus 2 and this sulfur is plus 6. Why, sir? This is sp2 hybrid. This is sp3 hybrid. Sp2 is more electronegative. Sp3 is less electronegative. So the bond is with the more electronegative atom, electron shifted towards more electronegative atom, minus 2. Here, plus 2, then plus 2, then plus 1, then plus 1. Total plus 6 and minus 2. So when this conversion is happening now, so plus 6 becoming plus 6, so conversion is not. What is plus 6 to plus 6? Nothing. Actual conversion was minus 2 to plus 6. तो भाई साहब I माइनस टू ओनली जीरो इकड़ा, I माइनस टू प्लस फाइव अकड़ा, सल्फर फ्रॉम माइनस टू टू ओनली जीरो, हियर द सल्फर फ्रॉम माइनस टू टू प्लस सिक्स रीच्ड, चमका। दिस वे यू कैन रिमेंबर मोर इजिली द रिएक्शंस। लास्ट रिएक्शन दैट दिस MnO4 माइनस इन द फेंटली अल्कलाइन मीडियम विल कन्वर्ट Mn2 प्लस टू MnO2, दैट इज वाई इन द बेसिक मीडियम Mn2 plus is not stable. It happily get converted to MnO2. Why? Because his own brother MnO4 minus in the alkaline medium oxidizes him. These are the reactions of K2Cr27KMnO4. Then, bhai. Then, Shri Prasad and Pamsam Yu got tuberculosis diho. Engineer Tim. Why blue? Several times I've told this thing, so I'm not writing the trick anymore on the top. I just orally spoke the trick. So Shri Prasad and Pamsam Yu got tuberculosis diho, engineer Tim, why blue? Shri Prasad and Pamsam Yu, U is F7S2. Gadolinium, F7D1S2. One question came in the JEE Main this year. Ki gadolinium plus 2 configuration, plus 2. Plus 2 means always S electron will go first. So configuration will be F7D1. ठीक है भाई, देन नेक्स्ट इंजीनियर टीम वाई ब्लू, तो वाई बी इज एफ फोर्टीन एस टू एंड एल यू इज एफ फोर्टीन डी वन एस टू, सो ल्यूटीशियम ऑल्सो दे कैन आस्क यू ल्यूटीशियम प्लस टू एफ फोर्टीन डी वन। नाउ अंडरस्टैंड, श्री प्रसाद एंड फोर डाई ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस, सो भैया श्री प्रसाद एंड फोर 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 डाई फोर ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस फोर ऑल दिस शो प्लस फोर, द मोस्ट स्टेबल फॉर ऑल ऑफ देम द मोस्ट स्टेबल ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज प्लस थ्री, तो प्लस फोर टू प्लस थ्री इज रिडक्शन, सो दे आर गुड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स। हु कैन शो प्लस टू, तो यूरोपियम यार इज एफ सेवन एस टू ना, तो यूरोपियम प्लस टू विल बी हाफ फिल्ड एफ सेवन and YB plus 2 will be half fully filled F14, but they are shy people, so europium bring samarium with him, YB bring TM with him, so bhaiya SM2 plus also TM2 plus also exist, so these show plus 2 to plus 3 conversion happily oxidation, so they are reducing agent. Most paramagnetic neodymium used as analytical reagent, cerium plus 4 is used as analytical reagent. His SRP value is 1.74 volt, which is very high, higher than KMnO4, 1.5, lesser than cobalt 3 plus, 1.97 volt, clear, lesser, more than Mn3 plus also. Cerium is a very good oxidizing agent, but it does not oxidize water at room temperature, kinetically inert, does not oxidize water at room temperature. So very good analytical reagent, will not oxidize the medium, but will oxidize the substance I'm sending. Next, samarium, steel hard and very high melting point. So this is about the 4F elements. All of them, they form the compounds of LnOH whole thrice, LnX3, Ln2S3, Ln2O3. All these are plus 3 compounds of lanthanoids. Only you have to remember carbides here. So Ln3C, Ln2C2, Ln2C3. These are the carbides you get. 3, 2, 2, 3. क्लियर भाई, चलिए देन अबाउट द 5F सीरीज, व्हाट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई दे शो मेनी ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट्स, बिकॉज NS N माइनस वन डी एंड N माइनस टू एफ एनर्जीज आर क्लोज, क्लोज एनर्जीज आर देयर टू ईच अदर, फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 7S 5D सॉरी 6D एंड 5F, दीज एनर्जीज आर वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर. Because of that, the last two planets of our solar system, Neptune and Pluto, these show the highest oxidation state up to plus 7. Next two, Uranium and AM, they show up to plus 6. So many oxidation states are shown. Reactivity wise, their reactivity is like normal metals. They react with acid, yes. They react with HNO3, yes, but protective oxide formation. In the last class also I said, Actinoid also I said, I mentioned in the last class, lead, actinoids, all these I mentioned in the last class, chromium, aluminium. Next what? Next, they don't react with alkali, they don't react with base because they are metals. Metals are basic in nature. Basic and basic, no reaction. Now, actinoid contraction is more than lanthanoid contraction if they ask you. And if they ask you magnetic susceptibility, then lanthanoids have more than actinoid. Magnetic susceptibility means more affected by the external magnetic field are lanthanoid and not actinoids. Clear, bhai? Done. In fact, they react with the steam also. They react with the steam as well. They form oxides and hydrides when they react with the steam. But not very important reactions. This is about the 5H series. End of the story. Going ahead. Coordination compounds. In the coordination compound, the most important thing starts from the Werner's theory. But before that, nomenclature you can see once. So, well, Werner is, you can start. Werner. Understand now. Werner theory. If you write COCl3.6NH3, 5NH3, 4N4, yellow, purple, green, violet color, you have to remember. 6NH3, understand, inside the box, firstly, coordination number 6 and ammonia will be always preferred. So ammonia will be 6 inside. All 6 we got, coordination number. So all the 3 chlorine will be outside. This is called free ion. And free ions will make precipitate, so 3 moles of PPT. So someone say a complex is there of cobalt and ammonia and Cl minus giving you 1 mole of precipitate, what must be the structural formula or what must be the molecular formula? Simple funda. If 1 mole of Cl, AgCl coming na, 1 mole of AgCl, that means 1 Cl is outside. Remaining cobalt inside, 2 Cl will be inside. And how many NH3 required now for coordination number 6? 4. Now, this is A4B2 type. We call it A4B2 type. That means this 2 Cl can come at cis of each other or trans of each other. So 2 Gi are possible. So that's why there are two different colors coming, even though the formula is same. COCl3, 4NH3, COCl3, 4NH3, 2 Gi are coming. Why 2 Gi? Because Cl2, that means 2 Cl can come at cis of each other or trans of each other, 2 Gi are possible. Werner's theory, basic elementary question. Next what? Next you have the nomenclature. So tetraamine, NH3, 4. Aqua, achcha manchinilu also there. Chloride, Cl minus also there. Cobalt is the central atom. Oxidation state is +3. So it is zero, Cl is -1. So +3 here, -1 here, total charge will come out to be +2. So how many chloride will be written outside? How many Cl minus outside? For +2, you will have to write 2 Cl. Always understand free ion numbers are never mentioned in the name. You will never write dichloride in the name. So then how will I know that how many Cl minus are there? By checking the charge. Clear? Next, writing the IUPAC name for these compounds, you can check. Let's take this example. Always cation named first and then anion named later. Whosoever is the cation, whosoever is the anion now. This box is written first. This box, this complex is cation. Cl minus is the anion. I will name the complex first. In the complex, in coordination sphere, always the ligand is named first. Ligand named first. So what's the ligand? Amine is there, carbonate is there. Two ligands are there. Such kind of complexes are heteroleptic. Two or more than two types of ligand, heteroleptic. All the same ligands are there, like this one, homoleptic. This one, homoleptic, only oxalate, only thiocyanato. Clear, bhai? Now, understand, when you have heteroleptic, go alphabetically, so amine comes first. So pentaamine, 5-amine, pentaamine carbonato. Whenever the ligand is negatively charged, his name will always end with O. Clear, bhai? Carbonate means free ion. Carbonato, ligand. Chloride, free ion. Chlorido, ligand. Nitrate, free ion. Nitrato, ligand. O, ending with O means ligand. Now what? Bhaiya, pentaamine carbonato. Bahut badhiya. Then cobalt. Cobalt. In the bracket oxidation state, bhai. Carbonate is -2, the whole world knows. If you are outside the world, you are out of the world. So, bhaiya, I cannot help you out. But carbonate people know are CO3 2-. A few moments back also I said CO2 goes into water, CO3 2-. NH3 is a neutral compound, zero. Cl is -1. Total -3. So cobalt should be having +3. So write that in the Roman numerals in the bracket. After that, free ion. Free ion is chloride. Anion. If the complex is negatively charged, if the box is having a negative charge, that means box is written on the right side, then the name of central atom ends with 8. What's the meaning of that? Here, cation is free ion. So I will write potassium. I will not write tripotassium. I will write potassium. Then oxalate, I can write trioxalate also, tris also. Both options are there for me. Tris also, tri also. But if the name of the ligand has di, tri, tetra itself, like ethylene diamine, name has di. Ethylene diamine tetraacetate, name has di also, tetra also. For the number of these ligand, like EN, written, I will not say ethylene diamine. Name has di already. So di, tri, tetra will not be used. Bis, tris, tetra, kis will be used. So ethylene diamine 3 means tris ethylene diamine. Tris ethylene diamine. Understood the idea? So you will write potassium. Tris oxalato. Potassium, tris oxalato, tris. You can also write tri. There is no problem in this because oxalato name does not have bi tri. So both options are there. Clear? So can I use the same option with Cl minus also? Nah. For big ligands. Big ligands like H2O, NH3, you can use there. Bis, tris also, di, tri also. Clear, bhai? But compulsory to use bis, tris for ethylene diamine and EDTA. Chaliye. So tris oxalato or tri oxalato. Then chromium in the bracket oxidation state, third, this will be wrong. Why? Because the complex, the box is on the right side. So rather than writing chromium, I have to end the name with chromate. 8. So potassium, free ion. Then trioxalato, chromate third. Chromate means +3. Sorry, chromate means the name ending with 8 means the box, the complex is on the right side. The complex is negatively charged. Clear, bhai? Practice these questions, you will be able to get. Spectrochemical series, bhai, how to remember? See, Cn minus and Co, they form synergic bond. That's why they are the topper. Try to understand. Metal here, Co here. Co has empty pi star orbital giving a lone pair by sigma bonding. Empty pi star is there. Metal have, let us say, lone pair. So metal lone pair will be delocalized in this pi star. So double bond tendency comes na yaar. Double bond means chala attraction. Chala attraction means what? Chala attraction means the ligand will be very close to the central atom. So very strongly it will behave. What is the meaning of strong behavior? More repulsions he can do. He will come closer, more repulsions he can do. So what will happen? Co will be the best. Because of this synergic bonding, what happens? Because of synergic bonding, the electron enter into pi star of Co. This is chadda orbital. So bond order decreases, bond length increases of carbon-oxygen bond. So carbon-oxygen bond becomes weaker and longer because of synergic bonding. Clear, right? In the synergic bonding, the ligand accept the electron. The ligand will accept the electron. So Cn minus is there, na? Cn minus, he is a negative ligand. Negative will not be able to attract the electron as much. So that's why lesser synergic bonding, so lesser. Firstly, carbon donors. Tarvata, nitrogen donors will come. Nitrogen donors. Tarvata, oxygen donors will come. See how to remember. And tarvata, halogen and sulfur. See, bhai, how to mug up? Carbon donors first, and both the carbon donors are synergic bonding people, topper of the series. Tarvata nitrogen donor. See, ethylene diamine, di, rendu nitrogen, rank 1. Then amine, rank 2. Sonia, listen. EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetate. So diamine and contamination of 4 oxygen also came. Hexadentate ligand, 6 denticity. इट कैन मेक सिक्स कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड विद द सेंट्रल एटम, फोर विद ऑक्सीजन, टू विद नाइट्रोजन. तो लिटिल कंटेमिनेशन केम ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑक्सीजन इज वीकर. सल्फर तो इवन वीकर ना यार, सल्फर इवन वीकर. तो नाइट्रोजन डोनर करे बट अलॉन्ग विद द सल्फर इट केम, तो इवन वीकर. इज यू रिमेंबर? देन वॉटर, वॉटर H2O इज द किंग ऑफ द पुअर, इज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट वीक फील्ड लिगेंड. वॉटर then C2O4 2 minus, then OH minus will come. Then fluoride, chloride, bromide, iodide. But you have to adjust sulfur in the middle. So fluoride tarvata sulfur again, chloride tarvata HCN again. Clear? So what to remember? Carbon donor, nitrogen, oxygen, halogen and sulfur. Understood the idea? Where the NO2 minus will come? NO2 minus comes here. You can remember. NO2 minus comes here. Better than NH3. NO2 minus is better than NH3. Clear, bhai? Now, is there a logic behind the spectrochemical series? No. Then what did I just now do? I tried to make you this mug up. Clear, bhaiya? Now what we are going to do? We are going to see the method of finding the hybridizations and all. So simple funda is there, bhai. For example, I start with Ni H2O whole 6 2 plus. Understand? Carbon nitrogen donors are strong field ligands. Done. For cobalt 3 plus, carbon nitrogen donor and C2O4 2 minus and water are a strong field ligand. This is the only exceptional case for us, which we have to discuss now. Clear? Then, these three orbitals are T2G, these two are EG. EG-EG pairing not allowed in coordination number 6. But, if you get similar kind of situation in coordination number 4 or coordination number 5, then this kind of pairing will be allowed. But allowed in the presence of a SFL, obviously, that's basic common sense. Clear, bhai? So now, NiH2O whole 6, 2 plus, what you will get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then, bhai? H2O is a weak field ligand. If I replace H2O with ammonia also, nothing is going to happen. Why? He's a strong field ligand, but because I already said the first three are T2G, next two are EG, coordination number 6, this pairing not allowed, so you have no other option except going out and finding empty orbitals for coordinate bonding. sp3d2. This kind of complex is called outer orbital complex. Any pairing happened? No. No pairing happened means high spin complex. Outer orbital, high spin. So remember, D8, D9, D10 always are going to be outer orbital complex, sp3d2 in coordination number 6. Someone asks you mu. So mu will be 2 point something Bm. Someone asks you paradia, 200 electrons of paramagnetic. These are basic thing that people know before writing the NEET examination. You are not waiting for coordination compound to learn paradia. And if you are waiting for it, then you are too late for it already. So read that topic. Coordination is not for you then. Clear, bhai? The coordination, para, dia, mu, all these are bachkand thing, kiddish things. Clear? Coordination is a heavier topic. Now, if I write NiCl4 2 minus, what will happen? Again, nickel plus 2, again D8. D8 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Cl minus weak field ligand. Pairing will not happen. Why? Because weak field ligand is there. Now, problem is not coordination number. Problem is weak field ligand here now. So what hybridization will come? Coordination number 4 means I will go with sp3 now. I don't need so many orbitals. sp3d2. 6 orbitals I don't need. 3 plus 2 plus 1, 5. 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, 6. I don't need 6 here. I need 4 only. So sp3 I will get. This is called tetrahedral. Again, the magnetic moment will come 2 point something. If I write Ni, Cn whole 4, 2 minus. Now the twist in the story comes. Again, nickel is plus 2. Nickel plus 2 is D8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now there is no T2G-EG. Why? Coordination number 4. No T2G-EG. Then, strong field ligand is there? Yes. Pairing will happen? Bilkul happen, sir. 100% will happen. You will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Coordination number 4, it is allowed. Will you have an empty D inside? Yes. So can I get DSP2? 100% sir, DSP2 possible. This is called a square planar. If they ask you what is the D in the DSP2, it is the X squared dash Y squared. dx square dash y square. Done, bhai. In case they will not ask, in case they ask you this d also, this is dx square dash y square and dz square. They will not ask, but still if they ask, you can answer. So dx square dash y square, dsp2 you are going to get. Done. Now, one more thing. If they ask you COC2O4 whole thrice, 3 minus. That means cobalt will come out to be 3 plus. Cobalt 3 plus is D6 configuration. You can check cobalt is S2D7. Cobalt is atomic number 27. S2D7 shortcut we can use. So cobalt 3 plus will be D6. If I write D6 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First three are T2G, next two are EG. Can I pair the electron back here? Yes, sir. EG to T2G pairing allowed. But there should be a strong field ligand. And this is a weak field ligand generally. But here, C2O4 2 minus is SFL. Not with cobalt 2 plus. Nah. Not with cobalt. Bilkul nahi. Cobalt only I said. Not any random. Sir, you only said, sir, cobalt. I did not say cobalt. I said cobalt 3 plus. Clear, bhai? Very important question in NCERT. What you will get? What you will get after pairing the electron inside? You will get 2D empty, so D2 sp3. This is called inner orbital complex. Electrons paired or not paired? Yes, sir, paired. So it is para-dia first. Sir, all of them are paired. It is dia. Electron got back paired, so I will call it, low spin complex. It's also called spin paired because back pairing occurred. If you have to find CFSE, crystal field stabilizing energy, that is the number of electrons in T2G multiplied by minus 0.4 delta O plus number of electrons in EG multiplied by 0.6 delta O plus number of new pair into P. What does it mean? Check. In the case of D6 configuration, or you can directly solve here only, in this configuration, how many T2G electrons are there? Six. So CFSE will be 6 people with minus 0.4 delta O, 0 people with 0.6 delta O, plus how many yellow color pair can you see? So 2 extra pair came, new pair, 2 came, 1 was already there, 2 new pair came, so plus 2P. Clear, bhai? Done. If anyone is saying, sir, once more, same video, lecture will get uploaded on the YouTube also. So ho gaya tumhara once more. If you are able to see once more before the NEET examination, good for you. Clear? But if you are listening carefully, you don't need once more. Clear? Because this has been told many a times before. Clear? Without CFSE, the coordination is incomplete. But next, same to same. Remember, same to same for COH2O. COH2O whole 6, 3 plus. Same. Exact same answer will come for COH2 whole 6, 3 plus also. Dia. Very important. This is diamagnetic. Very important. Clear, bhai? Then, one more thing I'm writing here. Platinum 2 plus, palladium 2 plus complexes. Coordination number 4. Always square planar. Always square planar. No exception as such. Clear? PTCL whole 4, PTCL 2 BR 2, PTCL 4, PTBR 4, PDCL 2 BR 4. Cl2br2, anything. Coordination number 4, platinum, palladium, always square planar, no need to worry, always dsp2. Going to isomerism now. In the isomerism, structural isomerism, Lallu thing is there, for example, NO2 minus, CN minus, NCS minus will come. These are ambidentate ligand. They can form the coordinate bond with nitrogen also, oxygen also, carbon also, nitrogen also, sulfur also. So they can show which isomerism? Linkage isomerism. Example, M something something NO2 and M something something ONO. Make sure they should be isomer first. Any outside one Cl written, outside one Br written, you are saying, sir, they are isomers. They should be isomer at the first place. They should be having the same formula at least. But linkage different, linkage isomers. Then, number two, if you are exchanging ion, for example, CONH3 whole 5, ClBr, and Cl and Br can be exchanged, CONH3 whole 5, BrCl. So you can understand, if the ions are exchanged with the ligand, which is negative ligand, negative ligand and the ion got exchanged. In that case, we will call it ionization isomer. Simple. Same kind of exchange you do with Mancini loop. COH2O whole 5 Cl dot 2H2O. COH2O whole 6 Cl dot H2O. So if you see here, the Cl and one water molecule got exchanged. This kind of isomerism is called hydrate isomerism. And then the exchange happened between two complexes, one cationic, one anionic complex, like CONH3 whole 6, CrCN whole 6. And this is one compound, one cation, one anion, one compound. COCN whole 6, CrNH3 whole 6. So you can understand the whole CN and the NH3 got exchanged, or one can exchange, two can exchange. So yes, such kind of isomers are called coordination isomers. How many coordination isomers? Coordination number 6, coordination number 4. Clear by structural. Talking about stereo and in stereo, starting with GI. Coordination number 4, square planar DSP2. You will get geometrical isomerism. But for SP3, you are not going to get geometrical isomerism. So game over. But for square planar, optical isomerism not there, bhai. So whatever geometrical you will get, that's it. Those are your stereo, no optical isomerism. Example, PtCl2Br2. Make pairs. Take chlorine as A for simplicity and bromine as B for simplicity. A2B2. So I will get AABB. I'll exchange them AB. So I'm going to get, this is one form, this is another form. Two forms are there. These are called 2GI. Everyone try once. PtClBrI2. Fadafat. Everyone try. PtClBrI2. PtClBrI2. How many isomers are you getting? Try to make them pairs. Take as Cl as A for simplicity. ABC2 will come. Try to make trans pairs, everyone. Cis trans nahi bhai. How many are coming? I'm asking. Two coming. Cis trans. This is also cis trans only. Yeah, ABCC. Firstly, I will put in the first form. This is one form. A and A can come together, C and C can come together. Then I will exchange ACBC. So again, I will get only two form. There are 2GI. Understand, there is no optical isomerism at all. Clear? Next. PtClBrFi. In such case, you are going to get ABCD. So ABCD. A can come with B. A can come with C. A can come with D. If A comes with C, B and D together, A comes with D, C and B together. So there are 3GI. If they ask you how many cis, how many trans, so you will say 2 cis, 1 trans. Sir, how? Live how long? How cow time gone? Clear, bhai? This is relative. I have taken A and B as my reference. I did not understand what's the meaning of reference, what you have taken, leave that. Remember, 3 came, 2 cis, 1 trans. Now, coordination number 6. Start with MA3B3, like CONH3 whole 6, NO2 whole, sorry, CONH3 whole 3, NO2 whole 3. So what you will get? You will get MA3B3. So you can write AAA, 3A. Then BBB, 3B will come. Now what? Now I can take this AB constant, exchange the remaining two boxes. I will get AB. I will get 2GI. Whenever you get AA in a box, or BB, or CC, or DD, same ligand in a box, or a set of ligand repeated, AB, BC, AC, these are optically inactive. When we are talking about only monodentate ligand, don't apply anywhere else. For example, here AA came, here AB came. In both case, optical activity not there, only 2GI, no other isomers. If you write M ए टू बी टू सी टू हाउ टू मेक द आइसोमर्स चेक ए ए बी बी सी सी लल्लू इज एग्जांपल यू कैन प्रैक्टिस यार ए फोर बी टू टाइप यू कैन प्रैक्टिस ओरली आल्सो यू कैन डू नाउ ए टू बी टू सी टू ए बी बी सी सी व्हाट आई विल डू आई विल मेक अ बॉक्स आई विल एक्सचेंज द रिमेनिंग टू तो बी सी बी सी नेक्स्ट बिल्कुल दिस इज कॉल्ड फैकमर आइसोमरिज्म फैकमर फेशियल मेरिडोनियल ठीक है भाई साहब डन फेशियल मेरिडोनियल नाउ ए ए बी बी सी सी तो ए ए आई टेक कॉन्स्टेंट बी सी बी सी एक्सचेंज नेक्स्ट वट नेक्स्ट टेक द बी बी कॉन्स्टेंट इफ आई टेक बी बी कॉन्स्टेंट बिग बॉस कॉन्स्टेंट ए सी ए सी आई विल गेट ए सी ए सी आई एम टेकिंग द सी सी कॉन्स्टेंट आई टेक सी सी कॉन्स्टेंट हियर तो आई विल गेट ए बी एक्सचेंजिंग द रिमेनिंग टू नाउ आई विल टेक बी सी कॉन्स्टेंट If I take BC constant, what will I get? If I take BC constant, exchange the remaining two, I will get AB, AC. Now I will take BC constants are already BC, you have taken constant, no need to take again constant. I will take now AC constant. If I take AC constant and exchange the remaining two, I will get AB, BC. So here BC, AB, AC, matching, matching. As soon as matching is started, no need to check again. So how many GI you got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 GI. Identify the optical isomerism here, bhai. Simple funda. AA came, not active. AA came, not active. BB came, not active. AB, AB came, not active. Here, nothing came, bhai. No AA, BB, CC, no AB, AB, BC, BC, AC, AC. So this is optically active. So total 5 GI, 1 optically active. Total stereoisomers will be 6. For didentate, what you will do? For didentate, you will remember. Clear, bhai? Didentate, you will remember. What you will remember? See, bhai. When you have one didentate, I'm talking about coordination number 6. One didentate ligand is there. One didentate and 4 monodentate are there. Then M, let's say EN hold twice CL4. So GI, VI, kuch nahi, nothing. All the 4 ligands same, nothing. But if you get one didentate, and 2 different ligands, then 3 GI will be there. Sir, how? Very simple. Ignore EN. CL2BR2. So CLCL can come at trans, BRBR can come at trans, and CL and BR can come at trans. 3 GI. Out of that, one will be optically active. Which one? Which is not symmetrical. CLCL, symmetrical. BRBR, symmetrical. CLBR, not symmetrical. That will be optically active. Then, if you have 2 didentate ligands and 2 monodentate, then what to do? Like M, EN hold twice CL2. Last question, last paper only this question came, bhai. I said in the last class also, bhaiya, forget your name from where you came, but don't forget this example. Ki bhaiya, whenever there are 2 didentate ligands and 2 monodentates, any different, same, doesn't matter. Cis trans isomerism, cis optically active, trans optically inactive. So 2 GI and total stereo isomers will be 3. And bhai, third case, 3 didentate ligands. 2 possibility, M, EN whole thrice or M, OX whole thrice. Clear? In M, EN whole thrice or M, OX whole thrice, what will happen? In this case, these are symmetrical ligands. Yeah. AA whole thrice, AA whole thrice. In AA whole thrice, you will get A. Any other possibility you are suggesting? So GI ledu, but all forms that you are writing will be optically active. Yeah, even though GI is not there, optical activity is there, stereoisomers will be 2. Understood the idea? Clear? GI not there, but stereoisomers will be 2. Then why? One is R, one is S. RS configuration. Then what? Then you have M. GLY whole thrice, glycinate. This is unsymmetrical ligand. Here you will get 2 GI and both optically active. So you are going to get total stereoisomers equal to 4. दिस इज इट डन भाई सर. हाउ टू जी आई केम आई कैन शो यू ए बी होल थ्राइज ए बी बी. क्या क्या करोगे जान के? वट यू विल गेट बाई नोइंग इट एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. टू डेज बिफोर नीट एग्जामिनेशन यू विल नॉट बिकम साइंटिस्ट ना. टू डेज 9, 10, 11, 12th is the NEET exam. So don't try to learn anything new which you are not able to understand. Just mug it up, get over the NEET exam, then forget it, throw it in the dustbin. Clear, bhai? This is about the stereoisomerism part. Clear? Regarding organometallic part, remember, when you have Mn2CO whole 10, there is no bridging CO. One. Next, when you have CO2CO whole 8, you have two bridging CO are there. These are polynuclear. There are two central atoms. Mononuclear, FeCO whole 5, that is DSP3 trigonal bipyramidal. NiCO whole 4, this is SP3. Very important, bhai. Very important example, SP3. NiCO whole 4, SP3 diamagnetic. Done, bhai? These are mononuclear. Done. CO means synergic bonding will be there. CO ligand means synergic bonding will be there. Boliye bhai. Done. Done. Next chapter. Metallurgy. Clear, bhai? Pi and sigma organometallic, if you want to revise, you can revise in the final time. I'm not going to waste the time on something which is not in the NCRT. Can come in the examination. Possibility is there. Clear, bhai? As the option, it can come. But very less possibility is there. Done. So by that logic, the gentle distortion is also there. By that logic, to what? One more thing came. Trans effect is also there. So, but we have to respect the time, na? Getting it? Just open the NCRT. Tell me which word of the NCRT I have not discussed. Ab you are doing PhD on 2 days before the NEET examination, then you are really seriously you need to get a checkup in the medical college, not the seat. 2 days before NEET examination, you are not even knowing what is there in NCRT and not in NCRT after completing the gene program. Others outside people, they don't know that is okay. They did not get the proper guidance. You are also having the same problem in life. And what was the whole objective of the gene program at the first place? Clear, bhai? So if you want to read, read. Nah, no one is stopping you to read. But in the class, don't disturb by saying, sir, this also, the Farmaishi program is not going on. Getting it? Sir, one song, this one also, can you sing? Kya? Sir, this one also, sir, 10 rupees, 20 rupees, like in Jagrata, it happens. Nah? Farmaishi are not going on, bhai, sir. Preparation is going on. 2 days before NEET examination, syllabus you don't know, then at least trust the teacher who is teaching you. Single word also not left. From the beginning till the end. Clear? Including denticity, venticity, coordination number, everything got completed. But ha, not writing, saying the coordination number 6. Whenever I've written a 2-didentate, 2-monodentate, coordination number 6. These are the things which are in a subtle way getting covered. Done? Not even a single thing left. So if you don't know the syllabus, please don't message at all. It becomes extremely demoralizing for a teacher. Bhaiya, after this much of effort, our student don't even know the syllabus. Then shame on us that we are not able to tell them the syllabus. Because Shri Goshalaks is the closest to the NEET examination pattern. And still our people are so poor in knowing the syllabus also. Then seriously, you have not attended any class properly. Any. Zero class. Clear, bhai? Because syllabus also you don't know. Outside people don't know, I can understand. You don't know. Or maybe outside people attending the class, that is also a possibility. Now they are thinking some magic will happen 2 days before. Chalo, let's start the magic. Maybe it can happen. Who knows? Some questions will click in the exam directly. Shall we check now? Last chapter. Clear? Yeah, video is recording. So I should not say the things to you. It will go in the public. That's why आई डोंट केयर. क्लियर भाई? यू थिंक आई विल बी थिंकिंग अबाउट द वीडियो? पीपल आर सेइंग सो मच आउटसाइड. इफ आई स्टार्ट थिंकिंग अबाउट व्हाट द पीपल आर सेइंग, देन व्हेन विल आई टीच? आई एम नॉट यू. कि सर माय फ्रेंड्स आर सेइंग दिस, सर व्हाट शुड आई डू? ब्रेक फ्रेंडशिप. व्हाट एल्स यू विल डू हियर? यू कैन नॉट किल देम, राइट? दैट्स नॉट लीगल. ब्रेक द फ्रेंडशिप, चेंज द मोबाइल नंबर, डोंट गिव इट टू देम. आफ्टर नीड सिलेक्शन इफ दे आस्क यू व्हाट इज योर मोबाइल नंबर, गिव देम योर ईमेल आईडी ऑफिशियल, doctorxyz@aimsdelhi.com. बस. क्लियर भाई? डन भाई? डोंट वरी व्हाट अदर्स से और थिंक. व्हाट मैटर इज व्हाट यू थिंक ऑफ योरसेल्फ. अदर्स मे से कि 3 days हाउ यू विल डू, 4 days हाउ यू विल डू. इफ यू स्टार्ट थिंकिंग दैट, देन देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम. क्लियर भाई? ह्यूमंस आर हैविंग इमेंस कैपेसिटी. इफ यू हैव डिसाइडेड दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डू, देयर विल बी अ वे इन विच यू विल बी एबल टू डू ऑल्सो. क्लियर भाई? There is a saying in Hindi, मन के हारे हार है, मन के जीते जीत. That means if you think you will be victorious, you will be victorious. If you think you are a loser, you are a loser. Again and again I say the same thing. You think you are going to be a doctor, you will be a doctor. But if you don't think you can be a doctor, then no one can make you a doctor. Clear, bhai? So firstly, rather than asking others, ask yourself, do you believe? And if you don't believe, force yourself to believe. Say this thing to yourself again and again and again and again and again and again till the time your heart believes what you are trying to say. Clear, bhai? Fake it till you make it. Done? Someone say you are not intelligent. Are chal, I am the most intelligent person. 3 days, how can you complete the whole syllabus? I can complete. 3 days are there, na? 0 days are not there. I can complete. I will read only some things. And those will come in the exam, but those things I will read properly. Those questions I will not do wrong. 3 days means you can. 3 days means you can at least see the marathon classes, na? So, syllabus will get completed in 3 days also. Question is how much confidence you have and when you quit. Yesterday I was discussing this with Akhilesh sir also. Ki we are teaching, but same question I am discussing in the study hour for the paper discussion. They are asking the same question. Then I only said one line, ki yaar, the problem is na, people want to, you know, get something miraculous happen, but they don't want to be the part of that miracle. They will not listen to 5-hour lecture with full concentration. They will say, sir, how can I listen? Arre, you have to listen. You wasted your 3 years of the life. Now also you will not listen, kya? So people don't want to listen for 5 hours also. Getting? We are here speaking. You can see in today's lecture, no break, because time is not there. If I take the break, how will I complete the topic? If you'll see here, a lot of things are lying here. Lot of things. But kya kare? I'm feeling like eating, but dekho, I'll show you. Ay, hai. Proper ekdam. See. Not even time is not there. Water is there, tea is there, but where is the time, yaar? And there I see the people switching off the video and having breakfast. But dedication nahi hai tumhare andar. Kahan se doctor? Kahan ka doctor? If you are not able to take your job seriously, which job are you going to get at the first place? Which company will hire you? Which job will hire you? Simple funda is there. If others have more dedication for your dreams, it is not your dream. It is forced upon you. Why I am teaching? For my dream. I want to make a mediocre student a topper in the last 3 days. Why not? I am not leaving even a single topic. because I know somewhere some person is there who might need this and who is talented enough to listen for 5 hours. And they will miraculously get selected, and later on they will say, sir, because of this lecture I got selected. I have a small dream. What is your dream? He said, wake up in the morning, then sleep for 3 hours, sir. After NEET exam, I will see the web series, sir. Your whole life ends at NEET examination. You know that. Getting people life begin after NEET, your life ends after NEET. After NEET, what to do? Sir, after that, no plan is there. After that, whatever the God will give us, that plan I will do. Clear, bhai? Chali, let's see. Last chapter of your NEET 2021 preparation of chemistry. Final. After the Sai Pohindi, one small news. It's not the last chapter of all subject. This is the last chapter of chemistry. Biomolecule, someone asking. Dekho, talent. Biomolecule, now they are asking. This is the problem. This is the problem. You are the problem. Ghochuram uploaded and online people asking. The years of hard work uploaded in four and a half hours and uploaded on YouTube. Teachers are seeing it to improve their subject. Here our own students are not seeing. Okay, sir, when the biomolecule got covered, sir. Coming to the main point. This is not the last lecture. After this, one small physics lecture is also there. Done. Akhilesh sir. Clear? He told me to say this thing to you. Done. So just that's why I kept you engaged, because he said 10:15. I know he will come by 10:30. I know him. Clear, bhai? And I need around 15-20 minutes to complete this topic. Clear? Someone is asking surface chemistry. Beta, that is in physical chemistry. At least subject to dekh le, ladki yaar. Subject to dekh le. Surface chemistry physical ka part hai aur inorganic ka nahi hai. Kaun si duniya mein rehte ho tum? Rehti hawa sa tha ho. कहाँ गया उसे ढूंढो हमको कल की फिक्र सताती वो बस आज का जश्न मनाता सरफेस केमिस्ट्री इनऑर्गेनिक में ढूंढता था वो कहाँ से आया था वो कहाँ गया उसे ढूंढो ना लाए थे चपैट सब्जेक्ट ही नहीं बना इनको ईयर खत्म हो गया सब्जेक्ट नहीं बना इनको सब्जेक्ट कौन सा चलो मॉर्फोलॉजी नहीं बोला दैट्स गुड मॉर्फोलॉजी डिड नॉट आस्क थैंक यू सो मच एटलीस्ट कैसा ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी तो पढ़ा दो वही रह गया बस चलिए और सर चाला इंपॉर्टेंट आउट ऑफ दैट बॉक्साइट ना AlOxOH3-2X यस Al2O3.XH2 इज द सेकंड बेस्ट आंसर बट AlOxOH3-2X इज द बेटर आंसर रिमेंबर दिस नाउ Siderite, FeCO3, FeS2, CuFeS2, remember together, both are pyrites. Iron pyrite only FeS2, copper pyrite is CuFeS2. Malachite is basic copper carbonate 2018, I think, NEET examination. Basic copper carbonate, CuCO3.CuOH whole twice. Then, cuprite, copper blends are easy, zinc blend, ZNS, calamine, lectocalamine, ZnCO3, 2019 it came, yes. Then zincite ZNO. Now understand what is the whole metallurgy. I'll cover the whole metallurgy here. Chinna alphabets I will write. Metallurgy. Number one, concentration of ore. In concentration or cleaning of ore or benefaction, we call it benefaction. Cleaning of ore. Number one, what we do? In the benefaction of ore, we can do the gravity separation. That is hydraulic washing. Hydraulic washing. What happens? Density is different. That is how the substance gets separated. So we wash using the stream of water. So lighter particles flows down with water and heavier particles settle. Just like washing the rice in your house. The rice particles settle in water and the husk particles float and come out. That is the gravity separation, hydraulic washing. Number two, magnetic separation. In magnetic separation, example is iron ores. What we do, we take magnetic rollers and the ore, crushed ore is circulated again and again. So what will happen? The magnetic part will stick to the magnetic roller and fall down later. And the non-magnetic part will go ahead because of inertia. So that's how we will separate the magnetic part from the non-magnetic part used for the iron ores for the concentration or cleaning of the ores. Number three, use froth flotation. In the froth flotation method, it is used for sulfide ores majorly. Here we have collectors. Who are the collectors? They collect the ore. Who are those? Sodium ethyl xanthate. Apart from this, the helpers are pine oil and fatty acid. These are collectors. So what they do, they ore is wetted by oil preferentially. Preferably O for ore, O for oil. The oil will go and cover the ore. So ore will get a coating of oil, so water cannot touch it. Impurity get wetted by water. Water surrounds the impurity. So they are separated. Now the collector will come, sodium ethyl xanthate. He will come, hold the ore and take him to the surface. Again, what happened? Pine oil and fatty acid, they cover the ore. O for oil, O for ore. Ore now is not touched by water. Impurity surrounded by water, ore surrounded by oil. Sodium ethyl xanthate will come, hold the ore, take him to the surface. This is called froth flotation method. Here, the froth stabilizer you are using is Crisol and Aniline. These are the froth stabilizers we are using. Froth stabilizers. Next what? Next, in the froth flotation method only I can discuss firstly, complete concentration part only we can discuss first. In the froth flotation method, if you have a mixture of PbS, that is called galena, and ZnS, which is called zinc blend or sphalerite, zinc blend also, sphalerite also we can say, we add dilute NaCl or KCl. These will form the complex with zinc, ZnCn whole 4, 2 minus, and the PbS will come out as it is without any problem. So when there are two sulfide ore, you want to depress the froth flotation for one of them, I will use dilute NaCl. So dilute NaCl will react with ZnS, will form ZnCl whole 4 2 minus complex. So Zn is gone, only PbS left. Now you can do the froth flotation. Oil will come, surround it, xanthate will come, hold him, take him up. Froth flotation method. We can also depressed. Also depressed by maintaining oil to water ratio. You can maintain the oil to water ratio. Kuncham oil add, kuncham. So oil will go and cover PbS. Because kuncham there, to whosoever attract oil more, oil will go to that person. Kuncham. Clear, bhai? This way also the PbS can be froth floated. So by maintaining oil to water ratio, you can do that. Or you can also do by using the depressant, which is dilute NaCl. This is called depressant here. Depressant. Froth flotation. Then we have leaching. What is the meaning of leaching process? In leaching process, a suitable solvent is added, ore is dissolved out. Example, I will take bauxite. The bauxite I am taking contains the impurity of iron oxide, titanium oxide, silica. Listen to the story carefully because there is no once more going on. Listen carefully. I will react this with NaOH at high temperature, high pressure. NaOH is a base. Al2O3 is amphoteric. He will react with the base. Fe2O3. Basic, he will not react with the base, metal oxide. TiO2 metal oxide basic will not react with the base. SiO2 non-metal oxide acidic, he will react with the base. So what will happen? These two will be left behind. Major impurity left behind. What came? You got NaAlOH whole 4. So सोडियम मेटा एल्यूमिनेट एंड बाय प्रोडक्ट केम Na2SiO3। ठीक है, नॉट अ बिग प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज Na2SiO3 इज नॉट दैट मच बिग ऑफ अ इंप्योरिटी। मेजर इंप्योरिटी वॉज Fe2O3 गॉन। देन व्हाट वी डू, वी टेक कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, ही विल रिएक्ट विद NaAlOH4, टेक द सोडियम आउट, तो भैया Na2CO3 गॉन। What happens to aluminium? He will come out as Al2O3.XH2O. बहुत बढ़िया। Heat it to 1470 Kelvin. You will get anhydrous Al2O3. This is how pure Al2O3 comes. Just one thing. When you are adding CO2, you will also add fresh prepared AlOH whole thrice to induce precipitation, to motivate the aluminium ki bro, come and precipitate, I will send AlOH whole thrice, which is the same thing, this is and this is same, I will send him so that he get motivated to get precipitated. As a result, more and more precipitation will happen, precipitation will start quickly. So what happened, firstly reacted with NaOH, leaching agent NaOH, Fe2O3 TiO2 does not react, you will get AlOH whole 4, then add CO2, add some Al2O3, so all the Al2O3 will precipitate. On heating, you will get anhydrous leaching. Then we have Rajnikant method. What is Rajnikant method, bhai? Rajnikant method we use for silver and gold. Rajnikant method, cyanide extraction. Why Rajnikant method? 3-in-1, concentration of ore, extraction of metal, and refining of metal, all three in one process will happen. So we react this with Cn-. Again, HCn, bhaiya, don't ever use. And concentrated NaCn, KCn also don't use. Use only dilute KCn. What you will get in the presence of air, you will get AgCn whole twice or AuCn whole twice minus. Then you react this with zinc. Zinc is more reactive. He can form easily the complex. So ZnCn whole 4-2 minus. And you will get pure silver or pure gold extracted as well as efficiently refined. Cyanide extraction. This is also called oxidation method. Oxidation method for extraction, we call it. Cyanide extraction for leaching, we call it. We keep on changing the name depending upon the process. Concentration of ore, leaching. Extraction of metal, oxidation reduction. But the process is same. Cyanide extraction. Understood the idea? Dilute KCN or NaCN, both can be used. This is about the concentration of ore. Next, we have extraction of metal. After you get the ore cleaned, you will extract the metal. For extraction of metal, whenever carbonate is heated in the absence of air, we call it calcination. Calcination. This is calamine. This is zincite. And let us treat this with coke. Coke. We make the briquettes. Small, small bricks of zinc oxide, coke, and some silica. And we will heat them. So coke will take the oxygen away, will become zinc plus CO. Done by zinc plus CO. Then what will happen? This is the zinc over here. This zinc is rapid chilling. Rapid chilling is done. Then you will be able to get the zinc back. Why? So much high temperature is there. Zinc, just now we have discussed, zinc evaporate easily. Lowest melting point, lowest boiling point, non-transition metal, lowest enthalpy atomization, Mahalalu metal of 3D series, it will evaporate easily. So rapid chilling required, then only zinc will be coming out from here. Clear by one. Next. If you take sulfide ore, for example, Cu2S, if you heat in the presence of air, this is called roasting. You will get Cu2O plus SO2 gas. One more thing here, the Cu2S which is left over, because all the Cu2S will not react. Now something might be left over. That leftover will react with this newly formed Cu2O and they together form copper plus SO2. In this reaction, if someone asked you who is the reducing agent, so I will say reducing agent is sulfur in H2S, in Cu2S. Sulfur in Cu2S is the reducing agent. This is called self-reduction. Here you can see, we did not add any other reducing agent like coke. Here Cu2S only formed Cu2O and then Cu2O, Cu2S together reacted and they formed copper plus SO2. The copper you are going to get here is going to be blistered in the appearance. Why? Because the SO2 will go out from here. And this is called blistered copper. Blistered copper. All this process happen in a silica lined converter. Silica lined heater, we can say. It happens in a silica lined heater. Blister, pimple. Why the pimples will come? Because of the SO2 coming out of it. Blistered copper. Then, in the case of copper metallurgy, the impurity that we are having, impurity means gangue. The impurity that we are having is FeS becoming on heating FeO. This is the gangue. For removing this gangue, I add silica. Silica is the flux here. We will get FeSiO3. This is called slag. This happened in reverberatory furnace. So there are two furnaces in the copper metallurgy. Reverberatory furnace, slag formation major reaction. Silica lined converter, we call it Bessemer converter, but name is not there in NCERT. So silica lined converter, who is the major product? Blistered copper. What get transferred from reverberatory furnace to silica lined converter? We transfer Cu2S plus FeS. This is nothing but copper metal. Copper metal. So copper metal, there is Cu2S plus FeS will be transferred from reverberatory furnace to silica lined converter. So streamlined manner, you can understand why. Cu2S became Cu2O. Cu2O reacted with Cu2S becomes SO2 and copper. Copper we got, self-reduction method is there. Ballbadia, we also call it auto-reduction. This happened in silica lined converter. But before that, reverberatory furnace was there. In that, FeO was removed as a slag and copper mate was formed. Copper mate got transferred into silica lined converter where this reaction happened. Copper metallurgy. How to extract the copper from the low grade copper ore? Use the leaching process by bacteria or acid and then do the reduction by iron scrap or hydrogen. They are cheap. If the site is having aluminium also as oxidizing, as reducing agent, iron also there, both present, aluminium also, iron also. For reduction of low grade copper, Lallu copper ore, for the reduction of that, what I will use? Iron. Why? Sir, aluminium is more reactive. Yes, still we are using iron. Why? Cheaper. Low grade, na? I will not get good copper. So I will get cheaper version of that. For cheaper, I need cheap reducing agent. Done by, that's it. Next. In case of Cr2O3 and Mn3O4, we do thermite reduction. Thermite reduction will give me Al2O3 plus chromium and manganese. This is heating in the presence of aluminium. Thermite reduction we call it, or aluminothermite reduction we call it. Then, Allingham diagram here. Allingham diagram is chala simple. Lower line metal or element. Lower line element. Reduce upper line oxide. Try to understand the simple funda. Let's say a temperature is like this. Here, this temperature. At this temperature, this magnesium line is lower and Al2O3 line is upper. So lower line magnesium, upper line Al2O3. What will happen? MgO plus aluminium will happen. Lower line element, upper line oxide. But if I take a temperature somewhere here, you will see the lower line is now aluminium and the upper line is magnesium. So here lower line metal, upper line metal oxide. The reaction will be Al2O3 plus Mg. So this Allingham diagram tells us ki which reducing agent can be used for the thermal reduction. Pyrometallurgy. Pyro means heat. Pyrometallurgy. At point A, what happens? At point A, via Al2O3, enthalpy or Gibbs free energy of formation is equals to Gibbs free energy of formation of MgO. They are both equally stable. No one can reduce no one. No upper line, no lower line. Point of intersection. This point indicate change in slope. In the Allingham diagram, slope is minus delta S. Change in slope means melting point or boiling point, then only the change in slope happens. So at change in slope means something melted or something boiled. Allingham diagram part. The only line which is coming in the downward direction, if you see, is carbon giving you CO line. Here the delta S is positive. So slope, that is minus delta S, will be negative. Only carbon giving you CO. Last to last Rent test, this question came. Logically, it was explained to you also. Clear? Based upon the entropy, I explained the same thing to you. One line running straight, that is carbon giving you CO2. Delta S almost zero. So slope almost zero. Straight line coming. This is all about Ellingham diagram. If someone asks you, metal oxide become metal, toppers, listen carefully. Metal oxide become metal. So liquid metal more preferable or solid metal? Liquid more preferable. Liquid metal more preferable. Now, in the iron metallurgy, at low temperature, high temperature, which reactions happen, they ask. To understand, ki bhaiya, at low temperature range, FeO will not become Fe using CO. This reaction not possible. Otherwise, Fe2O3, Fe3O4, they can be converted to FeO. Fe3O4 can become Fe also. But FeO cannot become Fe at low temperature. This will happen only at 900 to 1500 Kelvin temperature. This way you can remember the low temperature, high temperature reaction. After using this, understand who is the Ganj here. The Ganj is silica, impurity. To remove this silica, Ganj, we use the flux, that is calcium oxide. Calcium carbonate, which becomes calcium oxide on heating limestone. CaO is the, kya rahi? CaO is the flux here. So you will get CaSiO3, which is slag. Done. Then the iron you are going to get contains only 4% carbon, then SP sir mange, impurity is there in the pig iron. Then pig iron converted to cast iron, how? By heating with the iron scrap here, 3% carbon. Then further what you do, further you add hematite, coke, plus what happens, little bit of flux also you have to add, such that this sulfur, phosphorus, silicon, they can go out as slag. Clear? So hematite added, you get wrought iron. Wrought iron is the malleable iron and the purest form of commercial iron. Clear? Impure form, pig iron. Most impure form, pig iron. In the aluminium metallurgy, what happens? Why? In the aluminium metallurgy, you have alumina, liquid alumina, molten alumina, molten. You are adding cryolite. Cryolite gives conductivity. Number one, it lowers the melting point. Same for CaF2 also. CaF2 name is fluorspar. Fluorspar. Then what will happen? We will take anode also carbon, cathode also carbon, but what happens at cathode? Al3 plus becomes Al. What happens at anode? At anode, O2 gas is evolved. O2 gas react with the anode and will become CO and CO2. So don't forget, if they ask you which gas is liberated, so here the oxygen is liberated at anode. Which gases are produced? CO and CO2 are produced. For every 1 kg of aluminium, 0.5 kg of carbon is consumed at anode. They become CO and CO2. So you have to keep on changing the anodes. You have to keep on changing this anode. Remove the clamp, new clamp required because carbon becoming gases. For every 1 kg aluminium, 0.5 kg gone. Then, refining by your distillation for those metal who are having low boiling point. Liquation, those metal who have low melting point. Low boiling point are who? Who have low boiling point by? Mercury is the example. Zinc is the example you can take. Low melting point, tin. Electrolysis we use for copper and zinc also. In the electrolytic reduction, what we do? We take anode, cathode. And here, anode is impure copper and cathode is pure copper. And what the solution is? Copper sulfate. So copper comes to solution and deposit here. So copper get deposited here. And here you get anode mud. What is the anode mud containing? Check, bhai. Anode mud. Complete, you have to remember the anode mud, bhai. Impurity from the blister copper deposit as anode mud, which contains antimony, selenium, tellurium, and happa. While discussion in the last class also, I told the same thing. Antimony, selenium, tellurium, and happa. So distillation, bhaiya, zinc and mercury, non-transition metals. Hai na? Liquation, tin, low melting. You take a slow, heat it, tin will melt and go. Distillation means boiling. Then, zone refining, bhaiya, what we do? The phenomena of zone refining, remember, phenomena. Phenomena is that, impurity are more soluble in the melt. So you take a rod, you melt the rod here. So with the flowing molten mass, impurity will flow down. At the last, this corner you can cut. Throw it away, that is the impurity. So impurity are more soluble in the melt. For ultra pure silicon, Indium boron, gallium indium we use. क्या? Zone refining, zone. Then Mohn's process is for nickel. Nickel plus CO gives you NiCO whole 4. So CO react with the nickel, impurity left behind. Then heat NiCO whole 4 at higher temperature, it will break to give you nickel and 4CO. Same for Van Arkel method, yeah. Zirconium and titanium. Zirconium, iodine will go react with zirconium, bring him out. Impurity left behind. Then ZRi4 is heated to 1800 Kelvin by electricity. Then it will break to zirconium plus iodine. Van Arkel method, Mohn's process, these are called vapor phase refining. Both are called vapor phase refining. Clear? Bilkul, correct. They are stable or unstable compounds. Here, these are stable volatile compounds. These are stable volatile compounds. Sir, unstable or stable? Stable. Why? Because for breaking them, by 1800 Kelvin required. Which unstable thing break at 1800 Kelvin here? So they are stable volatile compound. Not unstable. Clear, why? So two things require for vapor phase refining. What is that? Number one, they should be easily converted into volatile compound. And that volatile compound should break to give you the metal. Clear? A breaking to give you metal easily does not mean it is unstable. It means that it will break to give you metal easily, pure metal. Not any random compound. It will not react with any random compound. Clear, bhai? NiCO whole 4 is a complex here. Complexes are stable, so relax. Understood the idea up to here? This is the end of kya? Chemistry, inorganic part, mini marathon also over. So, last line will be only one. Kya? Never ever think it is over till it is actually over. Miracles happen. But that will not happen by asking, will I be able to do it? That happens by doing. Clear? So don't quit. Clear? With full hope, write the NEET examination. Full hope. And prepare also with full hope. Whatever you are reading, that only will come in the exam. And then read limited only, but read properly. Theek hai bhai? Bas. Done bhai? Yes, Akhilesh sir already came. So you can take a break of 10 minutes, 8 minutes. And you can come back at 10:30. Chali bhai. Okay then. Tata. Bye bye. Bye bye. Which I'm ending the meeting, you can join again. Okay? I'm ending the meeting, then you can join again.